There's good news when it comes to Superman. I don't know if you guys remember or not, but it wasn't that long ago where I made a video talking about the Superman marketing. Right here, is, it was called How Big Should Superman's Marketing Be? This was just 4 days ago. And here we are. We already have an insight and an answer into how Superman's marketing will shape up. And it starts off with an article that come my way where they're talking about Warner Brothers Discovery will be leaning in to promote the film Gun Puppy Bowl Hopes. Oh, my God. What's going on here? Even though the writer-director, James Gunn and David Corn's with Rachel Brosnahan's Superman movie won't be hitting theaters until next summer, hasn't stopped fans from talking. Now, if we're talking about this latter half here, now we're getting a better sense of just how much Warner Brothers Discovery plans on supporting the first film of DC Studios, Superman. It's this woman. Her name is Kathleen Finch. Who is Kathleen Finch? This is Kathleen Finch, ladies and gentlemen. She is the chairman and CEO of U.S. Networks at Warner Brothers Discovery. Chairman and CEO of U.S. Networks at Warner Brothers Discovery. That means all of Warner Brothers and Discovery U.S.-based television and marketing goes through her. All of the network-based stuff. Anything TV-related that is owned by Warner Brothers Discovery is going through her fingertips. She has the big tits. She's the big boss dog. She's running a lot of shit, especially when it comes to TV. Over 20 networks, including TLC, TNT, TBS, OWN, Investigation Discovery, Cartoon Network, Adult Swim, Turner Classic Movies, and the like. So, together, the U.S. networks deliver more than 127 million total viewers on average per month. She is responsible for 20 of the 25 highest-rated freshman series. Now, those of you guys who watch TV, you want to see what she's responsible for. She's responsible for Naked and Afraid Castaways, MILF Manor, Curious Case of Natalia Grace, Jared from Subway, Catching a Monster, The Prince and the Glee, Summer Baking Championship, and Chow House, right? Barbie Dreamhouse Challenge from HGTV, and the number one freshman series of the year, TLC's 90 Day Last Resort. Really doing things heavy when it comes to television, especially on the United States side. And why is U.S. marketing matter? Well, because this is the biggest market for film. I don't know, maybe India or maybe China. China may be coming up, but I think we're still number one. It's between us, India, and China. I think we're still number one for the biggest box office. So for the biggest box office in the world, the marketing matters because we have purchasing power. We have buying power, convincing us to go watch Superman. Now, if you're the type that likes to watch your 90 Day Fiancé or a Summer Baking Championship or whatever, and you're watching TV, you might get a commercial, and guess what they're going to hit you with? Because they own the network. Superman. Superman, Superman, Superman. Now, mind you, once again, U.S. networks deliver more than 127 million monthly viewers per month. They have the ability to put Superman in front of the eyes of nearly 130 million people per month. Per month. That's 360, 12, 1,200, 1,560. 1,000, 1 million, what's that? 1.5, 127 million, right? What is that? 1.5 billion? Is that 1.5 billion eyes in a year? So they got eyes. 130 million people per month potentially watching a Superman commercial. Now, you got 130 million people. That don't mean 130 million people are going to watch. Yeah, sure. But what they could do is they know when to put a commercial that they definitely want to see. So, like, say, you're going to be there for the start of your show. Oh, I want to see the show. And for the very first commercial, it may be the first or second, they have the analytics for it, but they know what commercial people actually stay there for the longest. And that's where they will insert the ad for, like, a Superman or like they said, a Barbie or a Harry Potter, because they know where you're watching. So imagine, boom, 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 leading up to Superman. Where are we at? We're in October. It's October, late October right now. Superman doesn't come out for another 7 months or so. So 8 months at this point, almost nine. So let's say they start hammering down the commercials for 5 months with 127 million total viewers. Let's make it 6 months to be fair. You're talking about almost a billion people, a billion views that your commercials have potentially been seen by. You know, repeat viewings and all that. Have you ever watched a show? For instance, let me use me as an example. I used to watch 24 on Fox every freaking Sunday. I think it was Sunday at 9. Every Sunday, I'm watching 24. It could have been 8 or 9. I think it was 8. I think it was 9. My Jack Bauer. Love 24. Great show. Every single time, they would always have... You guys remember those little boxes where they'd be at the bottom? New series, Wednesday at 9. And they would show it on the screen at the bottom advertisement. Yeah, my nigga. Superman. Remember when... I remember also, triple they would have combo. Ford commercials. I don't know what it was with Ford in 24, but there will always be a Ford commercial. They'll do a Ford Mustang, Ford F-150 commercials while I was watching 24. So now if I'm a guy in my 30s back then, I'm seeing all these Ford commercials. I might be like, subconsciously, you might get them. But I'm really going into depth with this because of the marketing is billions of dollars spent on per year for marketing. It is a multi-billion dollar industry, and it's that way for a reason. When you're told over and over, and when you're seeing something over and over again, you keep it with you. It's like watching a good movie. I can recite The Dark Knight 75% accuracy. Why? Because I've seen it a lot. Repetition. It becomes just a part of you at a certain point. Now imagine, is there a TV show commercial right now that you guys could think of that is stuck in your head? I could tell you, I can recite 10 of them easily. I'll give you something that's coming to my head right now. The best part of waking up is Folgers in your cup. Silly rabbit, tricks are for kids. Diet Pepsi, You got the right one, baby. I'm going old school. Now I sound freaking old as shit. We are Flintstone kids, 10 million strong and growing. I don't want to grow up. I'm a Toys R Us kid. And even if I could, I don't even think I did. Whatever. I got them all day long. Frosted Flakes, you know the slogan for that. They're great. We got them all day long. Let me keep thinking. As soon as I'm off live, a lot more will come to me. But see what I'm saying? Using this as an example. Those rings, those melodies, those jingles. If you have a structured settlement and you need cash now, call JG Woof Woof. 877 cash now. 877 cash now. 877 cash no. Are you insured? Yes. By survival? No. I can't take that ride. What's up? All day long. So anyway, I'm getting off track. I'm sorry. If they're approaching this, so I put respect on this woman's name. We know who she is. Her name is Kathleen Finch. She's the real deal. So this is the woman that's speaking over here, right? This is what she said. Superman is going to be incredible next year. And we have so many things planned on the United States network side to support it and to ride the superhero wave. So that I'm really excited about because I think that's one of the things that our company does better than anybody. We all lean in. And when it's something like a Harry Potter or a Barbie or a Superman, there are so many touch points for so many different people, men, women, children. Everybody loves it and everybody can come to it from a different angle, different stage of life. Finch shared during an interview with Variety. She also says, quote, "So the fact that we'll be able to celebrate it in different ways across the U.S. networks is going to be really fun. We have a lot of really cool ideas around Food Network and Shark Week and all kinds of things. So that's something I'm very excited to see next summer launch." She's already mentioning Shark Week, Food Network, and then there's this series, there's this situation with the puppies, right? Finch knows that we'll like to see Gunn take part in it, right? So a television classic, what is it called? You know what we want? We've already said that we want James Gunn to do, and I was able to ask him in a public forum. He's a huge animal advocate. We want to use him for the Puppy Bowl. The good news is we'll probably get him to adopt like 12 more puppies. So the Puppy Bowl is a thing across the U.S. networks. And they know that James Gunn's a huge dog lover. Why do we know that? Because, like on Jody's Corner, we covered it. Him with the new crypto announcement, seeing the dog. The dog, Uda? Oh, freak. What was the dog's name? It was a three. I think it was a three-letter name. Bad little motherfreaker that turned out to be good. Love the dog. Oh, loving Snuggly. And then inspired him to be in the movie. He loves dogs. Get it, boom, boom, ta-da. But imagine what I said earlier. If you're a TV watcher, or if you're not, you know somebody who is, who watches their Investigation Discovery, you know, will Michael, but Michael left down a final, a fatal flaw that will break this case wide open to the dome. He left semen on his shoe. They watched that shit. The 90 Day Fiancé. The bride this, bride, the baking shows, the HGTV stuff. Oh, I'm fixing up a house with $40,000 or less. Yeah. Watch me. Oh, my God. This budget is going to be so hard to do. Right? Yeah, right, husband. We only have $60,000 to get this job done. I don't know if we're going to be able to make it. By the end of every episode, we did it. Look at this beautiful house of yours. And they come in. Oh, my God. People love that shit. They eat it up. And imagine Superman being played behind all them goddamn commercials, bro. Oh, yeah, you better believe. When I said that Superman marketing gonna be the top notch, it's gonna be top goddamn notch, bro. Superman will be making the bread, bruh, because the marketing is going to be top tier. We about to put this shit and ensconce it in people's brains like we're a Hydra on the Winter Soldier. 9-9-B-9 freight car. Everybody will be knowing that Superman is dropping July 11, 2025, bro. And that's exactly why I said Superman's going to best out Fantastic Four in 2025, which will put into fruition and will solidify my statement that I said 4 years ago, that Superman will be greater than Marvel by 2025. The MCU will be worse than the DCU, basically. Motherfreaker. Jody's Corner, bro.